Hello folks, this is Rodrigo Worley, Extension Weed Scientist with UW-Madison. Today we're here at Arlington Ag Research Station, and I want to showcase a large-scale drift dicamba trial that we have going on here. So we have about 30 acres of soybeans that were planted in early June. On July 11th, we spray the center part of this field that has 8 acres of extant soybeans with dicamba post-emergence. And then the area surrounded it was all planted with non-extant soybeans. So we're evaluating drift, either particle drift or vapor drift into non-extant soybeans. A few things that I want to point out. This is the area that splits the field. So I have extant soybeans right here and non-extant soybeans. Our last nozzle in a 45-foot boom ran right here. So here you have direct exposure to the spray solution there. You see the non-extant soybeans plant dying. So again, it's important when you're going out to spray a field with dicamba to make sure you are on the right field. The other thing I want to show you is some of the off-target impact on soybeans. Here we get some classical dicamba injury to soybeans. You get some of that cupping that we're all familiar with by now. The other thing I also want to point out, I've been getting lots of questions and pictures of that, is this even milder dicamba injury here, where you get this leaf malformation, but then you see the edges there being a little white. So that's always, that's also, injury from a very low exposure of dicamba there. Okay. The one neat thing about this study, when we sprayed this entire area, was exposed, but this area here was actually covered with plastic for about an hour after application. So any injury that we supposed to be seeing here is supposed to be coming straight from vapor drift. And as you see here, we are seeing some. Okay, so a good indicator here that we do have particle drift in this field here, but we're also getting some vapor drift. Okay, according to the label, label says just do not spray soybean, just do not spray or extend soybeans if there is sensitive crops down the road. And this is a classic scenario here. So we were spraying this field. The one end was coming from the south. Okay, and this is the area here, right north of where it got sprayed. And you can see here that injury that's being caused by both particle and vapor drift. So for more information, just check the link below. We have a nice publication how, to help you identify and some of the best management practices when using the dicamba and extend soybeans. And if you have questions, contact your local ag agent, or feel free to reach out to us, whiskweeds.info, or on Twitter as @whiskweeds. Thank you.